So let's do a little reality check, okay? When it is a festival morning, we don't have time to wake up, wash our hair, set it, blow dry it, make it look beautiful, then do our makeup and then go do puja. At least for me, it's like wake up, immediately go to the washroom, wash my hair, maybe do, I usually don't do makeup also, like me later for pictures maybe I do, but I just wake up, wash my hair, put it into a clip, then go out, like do puja, then do everything, and then we end up feeling hungry after the puja, then eat. That's literally it. So I said that because I just washed my hair and I was about to blow dry and then film the video, and I was like, you know what, nobody is gonna blow dry that day, nobody is going to, you know, have that proper set hair, so I'm gonna do makeup like this, and nobody is even going to have time to do makeup. So I thought I'll keep it very, very simple. If in case you do want to do it, very simple, very easy, it'll maximum take 5 to 10 minutes for you to do this makeup. Fat you can do. So yeah, let's get started. So let's start off with moisturizing. I'm using the Sugandha Aloe Green Tea Gel. I'm just hydrating my face. You know, it's really important. Ignore my skin. It's going through a very rough patch. And here on camera, it actually looks way worse. I don't know why. And yes, it is actually a little bad, but we're gonna do what you're gonna do. Next, I'm just taking an eye cream from Estee Lauder and just hydrating the under eye as well before we go in with makeup. Then I'm just taking the Fenty Beauty on L'Oreal foundation. I'm just taking a brush. I mean, who is she? She's using a brush. I'm just using a brush because it's quite quick and easy when you use a brush to do your makeup. And if you don't have time on a festive morning, then brush is like the best way to do your makeup. So I'm just taking the Real Technique buffing brush and I'm just blending that foundation into my skin. Next, I'm just taking the Benefit Boing, I can never pronounce it, concealer, and I'm applying it. You can totally skip concealer, you guys. You can just go with foundation under the eye. I'm pretty jobless, so I'm using a concealer, but you can completely avoid it and just use a normal foundation under the eye as well. Then I just used a little bit of contour with the same brush. I use the same brush because everything looks very seamless and very blended with the same brush. So just use the KKW Beauty contour stick and I'm just bronzing up the perimeters and usually wherever I do. And also, if you want to see skin prep, you can click on this video on the left corner. It'll show you how I prep my skin before makeup. So I'm just taking a brush and blending out the concealer. I'm just using this brush to, you know, have more coverage. So like I said, if you're using foundation, you can go in with the same brush and then just blend it out. You don't have to do this extra step. You would avoid more 2 minutes and be more quicker with your makeup. Next, I'm just using my favorite Laura Mercier translucent powder. I'm making sure there are no creases under the eye using my finger. Finger is a very good way to blend your concealer, guys. So I'm just trying to blend it out and then I'm going in with a brush and setting that powder. If you saw my concealer creasing video, you would understand why I'm making that stupid face. The powder has to go inside the lines. So I'm just setting the under eye for now because there's something else I want to go in. I want to go in with a cream blush. So I'm just taking the Ruby Organics blush. I'm slightly tapping it on my face. Next, I just take off the excess of my hand and lightly blend it into my skin so that I just have that very soft touch of blush, nothing too strong. Then I'm going in with powder again and setting that part. Basically, I set my center of my face so that, because that's the place I usually get very oily. So I'm just setting it properly with the powder and locking it in. Next, I'm just taking the Benefit Precisely My Brow Pencil and just lightly filling these. See, these are the steps you can completely avoid, guys. I'm showing you all the steps included, but you can pick and choose what steps you want to do. So somebody who has thick brows, then you can avoid brows. If you're somebody who doesn't have a lot of pigmentation or scars issue, then you can avoid foundation. Just use concealer around the under eye or something. So pick and choose the steps you want to do in your makeup. This is generally I'm showing you in a whole. If you want to do like a full face of makeup, like simply and very quickly, then you can do this. So I'm just taking the concealer and I'm just applying it on the eyes. I'm not carving my brow. That's not the day. We don't have the time. And I just set it with loose powder. Then I'm taking the Maybelline Studio Gel Liner. That gel liner is extremely pigmented, but I'm taking tiny bit, little by little, and I'm just making a very soft line around the eye and creating a small wing outside too. Next, I'm just using a dark brown to set the kajal. Usually I use black if I want to intensify the color of the kajal, like if I want to make it more black, rich black. But now I just want it to be very soft, so I'm going in with brown. I'm winging it out a little. I'm even adding the same brown on the lower lash line. So I do have small eyes and I don't want to go in the lash line, that make my eyes a lot smaller. So I'm adding it on the lower lash line and blending it out. So if you have big eyes and if you like wearing kajal, then at this point you can just add kajal in your waterline and blend it out. Then I'm just using a very normal warm shade just to blend the edges out and make it a lot softer. I don't know why I don't like strong straight line liners or anything. I like everything to be very smoky, very blended. Next, I'm using the Wet n Wild contour powder and I'm just adding that as like a bronzer on my lid, and then I'm using that as a little bronzer as well. I'm just dusting the product off. Remember, we did use a cream contour, so you don't want to like overpower or do too much. So just adding a tiny bit and I'm just dusting it all over. And I'm taking the Nykaa highlighter and I'm just adding it in my inner corner. And this is the part I love. So basically, I'm just adding a new liner in my waterline just to open up my eyes a lot more. So if you have smaller eyes, this is like a great tip to just open up your eyes and give it a lot more definition. So because you added brown in the lower lash line, this kind of helps to bring out your eyes a lot more. So I'm just next taking mascara from Essence and I'm adding it. I really love this mascara, adding a little bit of highlighter. My skin is terrible, you guys, I can't even. Then I'm just adding a lip liner from Wet n Wild and just coating it. And this lipstick is something I love. I take Dazzler in the shade Walnut, a little bit of Bindi, a little bit of setting spray, and we are done. So yeah guys, that's it for the video. I kept it pretty simple and basic. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you did, then make sure you like, share and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.